Hey, what's up guys? Radku here, back with another Yu-Gi-Oh! Video, and today's going to be Megalith. Now, this deck is one of the coolest ritual decks ever. It was seeing some minor competitive experimentation before it fell off the face of the earth because people found out how to contest against it. Now, this is a budget variant, and I really, really like this deck. Like, this deck is so, like, dirt cheap. Like, I could pick up the whole thing, including the extra Foolish Burial and the few cards I put in the extra deck for, like, 25 bucks. It's really good, too. So, yeah, without further ado, let's jump right into the deck. Starting things off, I play 3 copies of Megalith full. So, this card is really, really good. So, you can ritual summon this card. If this card is ritual summoned, or with a Megalith card. So if this card is Ritual Summoned, you can target one Ritual Monster in your graveyard. This card's level becomes that card's level. Then add that target to the hand. During your main phase, quick effect, you can target one Ritual Monster. Ritual Summon one Megalith Monster from your hand by tribute or deck by tributing monsters from your hand or field equal to its level. So you can only do it once per turn, but it's a quick effect special summon from the deck. So that means you can use it during your opponent's turn. Sets up some disruption. Pretty good. Play 3 copies of Ophiel. You can, if this card's ritual summon, you can add one Megalith from your deck, except Ophiel. Then during the main phase, you can activate this effect, ritual summon one ritual monster by tributing monsters from your hand or field, including this card, whose level equal or exceed the ritual monster's effect. You can only use this effect once per turn. So this is an infinite searcher. That's what makes this deck so good. You have cards such as Ophiel that can infinitely search all your monsters. This can thin your deck out super quick and is literally the best card in the deck. And then full helps the consistency by being able to get into Ophiel during your opponent's turn and being able to combo off super easily. I play 3 copies of Megalith Haggith. Of this card's ritual summon, you can add one Megalith Spell or Trap directly from your deck. So, I was gonna play Portal at 1, but I decided to play that 3, which I'll explain later, and mainly your target for this is Unformed. So, Haggith is definitely really good, and then it has the same secondary effect. The thing about the Megaliths is that they aren't very good on their own, but they're definitely good to set up some walls on the field, and they're pretty good combo deck. I play 2 copies of Megalith Awk. If this card's ritual summon, you can if this card is ritual summoned, you can draw one card, then discard one card. Basically, just another free special. No, just another free draw in the deck. But the really good effect is the fact that it's another quick effect special summon, which does come up quite a bit, meaning that you can ritual summon during your opponent's turn to disrupt their play pretty well. Then I play 3 copies of Megalith Aerotron. So like I said, this is a budget build, so Aerotron at 3 is actually pretty good. So, you, quick effect, you can discard this card. Ritual summon one Megalith monster from your hand by tributing monsters from your hand or field whose level exceeds the level. When your opponent activates a card or effect that targets this card, quick effect, you can place one ritual monster on the bottom of your deck, negate the activation, and if you do, destroy it. So you can set this up as another beat stick on the field, and then basically just be able to loop that effect, because it really, so it is a once per turn, but like you can use it just every turn just to destroy cards they have. Plus, unless they can beat over it, they're really gonna have a lot of trouble just getting over this thing. Then I play 2 copies of Megalith Bethor. So this card's actually decent. It's basically just a numeral destruction. Like, it can destroy based off of the number of cards you used as material, which is pretty good. And then rounding off the Megalith cards, one copy of Megalith Phaleg. This card isn't very good. It's just an attack and defense gain monster, and it's just not very good, but I have it in here for the name. So going into the non, I play Cyber Angel Benton, which can search your send you of 1,000 hands, and I play 1 copy of Magician of Black Chaos Max, because this deck can actually make it. Then I play three copies of Senju of a Thousand Hands. So Manju of a Thousand Hands is kind of expensive, being at like maybe $3 to $4. So I couldn't really afford it in this build. So I decided to put Senju, which is only like $1 each. It's really, really good. You can search your ritual monsters. And the thing about it is that Manju searches your ritual spells as well, but you don't play any ritual spells in the deck because you can only identify ritual spells by the little icon at the top. But the thing is that Unformed, the only card that can spell card that can actually ritual summon, is one that doesn't ritual, or that isn't a ritual spell, it's a quick play. So that means Manju is essentially useless, but you can use Senju to search out your monsters. Like, because Manju can search your monsters, but Senju only searches your monsters. So, I mean, I personally think it's better, but like, tell me what you think down in the comments. I play three copies of Effect Veiler because it's Effect Veiler, plus it's the cheapest hand trap you can get. One copy of Monster Reborn because it's Monster Reborn and can get back your cards that you've been ritual summoning the whole turn. One copy of Terraforming. Terraforming is amazing. It can search out your field spell. One copy of Foolish Burial. This can set up your graveyard. Really, like, Foolish Burial isn't the best card in the deck, but I guess you have the Monster Reborn place with it. I play three copies of Megalith Unformed. Unformed is actually really good. Like, it's really, really good. It can special summon from the deck by tributing from your hand or field, whose level is twice the level. Or you could just give your monsters an extra 500 attack boost, which isn't very good. But the secondary effect is really broken. Plus, it's not a once per turn, so the effect that you can keep looping Ock to add your cards, and then you can loop Haggith to search your Unformed multiple times and then activate it, is how you can really roll into your combo plays. I play three copies of Megalith Portal. Portal is really good just because it sets up a precedent for protection for your monsters. The first time each ritual monster would be destroyed by battle, each turn it is not destroyed. If a ritual monster or a megalith is special summoned, quick effect, you can target one ritual monster in your graveyard, add it to your hand. So it's a hard once per turn, but it's still really, really good. Like, sure, you could cut this out completely and not lose a ton for the deck, but the fact is that I'm playing a budget variant, this is super cheap, and it's a great protection for your cards. I play three copies of Preparation of Rites. This card's actually pretty cheap, despite how good it is. This can search, since it searches level 7 or lower, it can basically search your entire deck except for these last few, which is pretty good. You can still search your Cyber Angel Benton off of it. You can also search ritual spells, but I don't play any in the deck because I decided not to spend the money to buy the incantations. I play three copies of Extra Foolish, just because Extra Foolish Burial can send your Herald, and Herald can get you into a free search, which is really, really good. Speaking of which, I play three copies of Herald of Arc Light. So this card is amazing for ritual decks. Like, I wonder if Dogmatica Megalith would actually be a viable strategy, considering the fact that Megaliths don't need the actual ritual spell in order to ritual summon. It's kind of unique in that way. But, like, I wonder if it would work, considering the fact that we have Herald. Like, Herald single-handedly makes any ritual deck good with Dogmatica. So, like, I personally really like it, but, like, tell me what you think down in the comments. So, any monster sent to the from the hand or graveyard is banished instead. You don't really need to worry about the top effect. The only effect you need to worry about is if this card is sent to the graveyard, you can add one ritual monster or one ritual spell from your deck to your hand. Not a once per turn. So that means you can use Extra Foolish Burial. Really, you just don't really have to worry about a ton of stuff. Like, pay half your life points, send one monster from your extra deck to the graveyard. You can only activate one extra Foolish once per turn, you cannot set spell or trap cards during the turn you activated it. So realize it says you can't set them. The only set card you'll play is Unformed, which even then you can just activate it that turn. You don't really need to worry about that. Like, Extra Foolish Burial is nothing but a plus on this deck. Now I have two copies of Gallant Granite. You could cut this down to one. It doesn't really matter. It's a free search of any of your Megalith cards, and it's really, really good. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the deck. Please like, subscribe, share, comment, let me know what you thought, and let me know if there's anything you would change about it. Would you cut out Effect Veil, or would you lower the amount of Megalith Portal? Because I really like Portal, because it's just another way to save your Megaliths from being destroyed, which is something that we desperately need in the deck. And all in all, it's actually pretty good. So yeah, that's pretty much it, and I'll see you in the next Yu-Gi-Oh! Video. Peace, guys.